Good evening, Wrightsville. Donna Pinckney here, bringing you this evening's devotion. Each Thursday night in August, we've offered you a devotion of a particular prayer practice. We've done that because we tend to overthink prayer. We hear people pray aloud these beautifully crafted, well-written prayers, and we think to ourselves, wow, wish I could pray like that. But that's not required. A prayer is simply a conversation between you and God. And so we wanted to offer some really simple prayer practices that might invigorate your prayer life, inspire your prayer life, give you a different way to live your prayer life, whatever that looks like in your personal discipleship. But we just wanted to give you some new opportunities. And for some of you, these practices were things you already knew, and some of you, they were new. And so we hope that you found them meaningful. The first Thursday, we talked about breath prayers, breathing in the name of God, breathing out a joy or a concern. The next week, we talked about the daily examine. Invite the Holy Spirit in. When were you closest to God? When were you farthest from God? Thank you for today and looking towards tomorrow. The next week, we talked about praying through the Psalms. We discussed how the Psalms contain all the human emotions and how you can likely find one that resonates with whatever the situation is in your life. And we talked about some different ways then to pray those Psalms, whether it be memorization or praying it aloud or whatever that looks like for you, paraphrasing, lots of opportunities. All of those are listed with the video. On Facebook, you can find a graphic that has all of these instructions, if you will, written down for you as a good reminder of what we've talked about. Today, our fourth and final Thursday of August, who believes that we're at the end of August, we're talking about walking prayer. And we tend to think of walking prayer or walking meditation, as some people would call it, as being something that's done in a labyrinth. We've offered a labyrinth several times at Wrightsville, and it is always well received and people enjoy it. We don't have space for one permanently, but it's not the labyrinth itself that people find meaningful, I think. I think so often it's about the intention, right? So that can be on your street, on the beach, at the park, walking prayer. It's just an intentional prayer while you move. So whatever that looks like for you, right? Sometimes I find it's easier to engage in a walking meditation or a walking prayer when I'm feeling sluggish and I need to move, or when I'm feeling antsy and I'm having trouble getting centered enough to pray. I find walking prayer to be particularly helpful in those circumstances. So what sets it apart from a regular walk? Intention and practice. So I begin my walking prayer this way. I set aside a time or a distance for the prayer. I'm going to pray for 15 minutes. I'm going to walk for 4 blocks, whatever it is, right? You set that time and you say, this is my prayer. This is my prayer time. And you ask God to help guide those steps and prayers. That's step number one. Ask God to be there. Ask God, because we know God's already there, right? Ask God then to be present in that prayer. And you be present in that prayer. Be fully present. No AirPods, no phone in the hand. Be fully present in that walk and in that prayer. And then begin by intentionally placing each step, one in front of the other. Just slowly walking, being very aware of your breathing, of your movement, being aware of everything around you. And in so doing, things will be called to your mind or to your heart, whether it be a person or a situation. And when that happens, when something is called or someone is called to your mind or to your heart, you hold that. You hold that name, you hold that situation, you hold that for a few seconds, a few moments, whatever feels right to you, and then release it to God. So if a person's name comes to mind while you're walking, then you hold that name and then you hand it over. Hand it over to an all-knowing, all-loving God. You hand it over. Release it. And when you come to the end of your time or the end of your distance that you've set aside for prayer, then you end by saying, thank you, God. Thank you for being with me in this world. Thank you for being present in my life always. Thank you for hearing this prayer. Amen. Okay. I think we can do that one too, folks. I feel good about it. I feel confident about it. You got this. You got this, Wrightsville. You've got this. So, folks, that's our last prayer practice for August. Hope, again, that you found some of them meaningful and beneficial to you. I would love to talk to you about it if there's any questions you have or any, just any words that you want to share with me about it. I'm easy to find. I'm Donna@WrightsvilleUMC.org, and I'd love to talk with you anytime I can. Look forward to seeing you again in person real soon, we hope. And in the meantime, God bless you. Good evening.